It's the Polterthup. Oh. Oh, scary. Scary. It's the scary Zora mouth, all wide open. We're gonna go to the Great Bay Temple. Excuse me. No! What are you doing sailing out in this storm? We died. Well, game's over. Golbez won. Guess we better go level up some more. Man, nice palm trees. I would totally, like... Man, I would love to draw something like that and, like, for one of my games. Palm trees like that. Can you imagine, like, doing, like running along like, in a platformer, like, against this background? That'd be so cool. Anyway, we washed up, and this cute girl found us, and then it pans up to this epic mountain. What am I... I'm narrating what's going on, but you can see perfectly fine, I assume, since you're watching the video. The Legend of Zelda Link's Awakening. Hey, everybody, it's the Boulder Cousin back with more. Damn it, I said back with more. This is Link's Awakening. I'm gonna play Link's Awakening as my last 8-bit summer project because I've been meaning to... Well, I haven't really been meaning to do anything. Oh, I didn't set my controls! Dude, you didn't get your controller. You're so stupid. You're so stupid, bros. You're so stupid. Anyway. This screen always was interesting to me. Like, first of all, the border, like these like multicolored blocks, it looks like something out of like Yoshi's Island. And then there's like these two random Armos statues. This whole screen looks like it came out of Yoshi's Island. Okay, what do we name ourselves? Should I name myself Old Gerputz? Should I name myself Gust? Should I name myself Pults? Normally what I would do here, because when I was young Gust, I would always name myself Yori on this, after my other character. Because back then I always did P5000, but there's no numbers here. There's no numbers! Let's see, do you have five spaces? You only have five spaces. Should I go Pult or Pulse or Gust? I don't know. If you name yourself Zelda here, something weird happens, actually. The music changes. I'm not sure if anything else changes. I feel like it might unlock, like, a second quest where enemies do more damage or something, but I don't even know. Sure, let's go with that. Pult. Alright. Here we go. We're awaking in our bed. It's a Link to the Past, but we're only taking up, like, half the bed. Hello? Hello? What a relief! I thought you'd never wake up. You were tossing and turning. What? Zelda? No, my name's Marin. You must still be feeling a little woozy. You are on Koholint Island. What the fuck is I love how, it, like, the text box just stops, but he keeps, like, sitting in the bed, sitting up, staring at her. Like, you just imagine him, like, what the fuck is going on? Hello? Follow the lane south to reach the beach where I found you. Since you washed ashore, lots of nasty monsters have been in the area, so be careful, okay? Well, Pult, you finally snapped out of it! Name's Taren! Hope you're feeling better. What? How did I know your name? You think it's weird, eh? Well, I saw it on the back of this shield! Yay! So happy. You got your shield back. Press the button, I'm going to set that to B. That's the wrong button. Okay. Oh my god. Push select. Oh, my where. I can see my where. My where. It's like, what? Oh god, I love this music. This song is called Sword Search, and it is one of my favorite. This song, pretty much on its own, this song, along with one song from Ghost Trick, is what inspired me to want to do something that I still haven't done yet. I want to do, like a top 5 prologue and endgame themes, like a top 5 of each of them, but it's in one video. And this is definitely going to be one of the prologues. I just love the way this music sounds. Like, you're going out, you know, it's like a new world. It's like perfectly encapsulates that feeling of stepping out into a new world and having such purpose because you know you gotta go find your sword. Hey man, when you wanna save, just push all the buttons at once! Don't ask me what that means. I'm just a kid! Well, it seems that after you save, you will start at the last door you went through. I'm not really sure why that is, cause I'm just a kid! Well, I'm not sure why that would be either. And I'm an adult! I'm not a part of this system! Anyway, come down here and you can push these Gordos. I don't know what the hell Gordos are doing in my Zelda game. Ow! But you can push them. And I should have pushed... Get out of the way, ass nose! Excuse me, and here's your sword. It's translucent. You can see the waves through it. Oh, hey, it's the owl.
So, you are the lad who owns the sword. Now I understand why the monsters are starting to act so violently. A courageous lad has come to wake the windfish. It is said that you cannot leave the island. Well, unless you wake the windfish. I thought he was going to say, well, the windfish still rests.
Somebody else says something like that later.
You should now go north to the mysterious forest. I will wait for you there, Hoot.
Okay. Well, let's pick up our sword. A sword, Archimedes! You found your sword! It must be yours, because it has your name engraved on it! So happy. So many of the dialogue, like the narration when you pick stuff up in this game is just so happy. It must be yours, because it has your name engraved on it! Like, jeez, man. Anyways, here we go, we got our sword. It's cool, it's nice to see the sword. See, there were two other Game Boy Zelda games, right? And it was the Oracle games, and in those games, the sword and the shield in the menu, they were green. They were the same green as your tunic. And it looked really weird. I don't know. It looked, like, not as interesting. Oh, it's Conga. I don't know that song. I can't pretend to know it. Dude, it's an alligator. Hi.
Welcome to Sale's House of Bananas. I'm Sale. This is my house. Actually, my hobby is collecting rare and unusual canned food. My brother is an artist, so I guess strange hobbies run in the family.
What's so weird about being an artist, huh? Huh? You saying something weird about being an artist? Now you can kill the Gordos. Man, imagine if it was that easy to kill Gordos and Kirby. That'd be amazing. Actually, it would trivialize a lot of platforming segments and make the game pretty boring, I bet. You know, sometimes enemies are invincible for a reason. Anyway, was there anything here? You can hit select to open up the map. Yeah, we didn't check out that last bottom left corner. This is the whole map of the game. You can see pretty much the whole thing here. I love this music. Apparently everybody else did too, because when Capcom made the Oracle games, they didn't even bother to write new overworld music. They just used this in both games. Both Oracle of Ages and Seasons use this music as their like main overworld theme. Although Ages does also have a second one because of its whole time travel mechanic. They have different music in the past.
Taking the throne.
All right. This is the library where we can find a we can find a book to help defeat El Malverde. Now that we have our sword, we can jump down the well. And get a piece of heart! You got a piece of heart! Press select on the subscreen to see. Yeah, where I can see my wear. I can also see how much wear I have. Oh, that's the photos. I thought that was going to be the heart pieces at the bottom where it says 0 out of 12, because there are 12 heart pieces in this game. Yeah, remember back when there used to be like a manageable amount of heart pieces in Zelda games? Of course, you know, I say that like it's some bad thing to have a ton of heart pieces, but I love Majora's Mask, and I think that game still has the most heart pieces of any Zelda game. Except maybe Twilight Princess, because Twilight Princess had 5 to a heart container.
Hoot, ho, brave lad, on your quest to wake the dreamer. Welcome to the mysterious wood. Much of mystery you will find on this uncharted Koholint Island. I'm afraid you may find it a trifle difficult to leave the island while the windfish naps.
That's what I thought he was going to say earlier when I finished that sentence before I advanced the dialogue.
By the by, have you ever visited the Tail Cave, which is south of the village? Go there with the key you find in this forest. The Windfish is watching Hoot, even though he's asleep.
Oh no, you've got a Guardian Acorn. It will reduce the damage you take by half. And it'll it'll also reduce the amount of enjoyment you get out of the music by half. Yeah, there's two of those things in the game. There's those Guardian Acorns, and then there's the other things, these little Triforce things called Pieces of Power. Called Pizza Power. It pretty much looks like a pizza, too. It's this big, you know, cream-colored triangle. Like, it's like the exact color of cheese. It might as well be a Pizza Power. But yeah. And as long as you have them, it'll play this music everywhere you go. And at least when you get the Pizza Power, you move faster. But when you get a Guardian Acorn, you take half damage, and that's it. You know, the Pizza Power at least gives you an additional effect beyond that. But, and sometimes it changes. Ugh, God. Get me out of here. Get me to a place. If you enter or exit a house, it'll return the music to normal. Thank God. Hello.
Double, double, toil and trouble. A toadstool makes powder for tricks. Coffee, please. How about a little whiff of shame?
Okay, sorry. If you haven't seen that episode of the 10-Minute Power Hour, oh my God. Where they play What's That Smell? Or whatever that game is called. Hey, it's a Pizza Power! You can feel the energy flowing through you! And you can kill anything in one hit! And you move faster! That's the reason why the Pizza Power is better than the Guardian Acorn, because you can move faha. You can move faha while you ha-ha. I don't know what ha-ha is. Who's this guy?
As a raccoon, my nose is very sensitive to stuff like dust and powder.
Man, if I could do an Osaka accent, of course, I don't think you could do an Osaka accent while you're speaking, or an Osaka dialect when you're speaking English. You know, that wouldn't work. You just gotta do a country accent, but that guy would totally have an Osaka dialect. The fact that it's a tanuki, you know, it makes me want to do that even though I'm voicing everybody in English, you know. I hate this room. This room is such a pain in the ass. It's such a pain in the throat. This room is such a pain in the ass because, like, if you stand on these things for too long, they'll collapse out from under you. But they put, like, four bats in here. I don't know why they put that in. This is, like, the first cave room in the whole game, and it's one of the most annoying in the entire Steve. Steve, the entire Steve. That's so stupid. That's a joke. That's actually a joke from... That's an in-joke of me and my families back when we used to play Super Smash Bros. Melee together. My sister once misheard the announcer saying, "Game!" as them saying, "Steve!" And, like, we joked about that for years. You pick the toadstool. As you hold it over your head, a mellow aroma flows into your nostrils. Tim's reaction to that in his LP. I rewatched his LP of this recently. It's such a good classic LP. And his reaction to that is so funny. Anything that gets a good belly laugh out of him is just always a joy to behold. Anyway, we got the coffee peas. So now we can bring them back to the witch and maybe she can make a little whiff of shame. I mean, after all, that tanuki said his nose is very sensitive. So maybe... Would you guys get out of my way? Jeez! Okay. I really would rather not die here. If you actually beat the game... If you actually can beat the entire game without dying, you actually get, like, a unique ending. Oh, hey! What's up, babe? Let's heal your wounds and get rid of all that stress. Close your eyes and relax. God, the great fairies in this game are... Great fairies are so hot. Like, they just know exactly what to say, you know? let's heal your wounds and get rid of all that stress. I mean, come on. I gotta go back. I gotta go up. You gotta go left and up. Excuse me, I didn't want to go right and through. I wanted to go left and up. Huh, I didn't know you could kill those guys in one hit with a spin attack. Because normally those guys make those little bitch slimes when you kill them. But that one didn't. Taking a dump.
I'm taking a dump
on a dump up on the can. And it smells like crap. Hey, dude.
Double!
Okay, sorry. Makes powder for tricks. Alright, let's get our fire rod out.
Ah, it has the sleepy toadstool, it does. We'll mix it up. Something in a jiffy, we will.
Oh, God. You ever look at her animation here and see that, like, okay, look at her eyes in this animation. Like, she has, like, two spots on her sprite where her eyes can be, but they overlap when she turns her head left and right. Like, when she turns her head to the right, her left eye lands where her right eye is when she's facing forward. So it's like, one of her eyes is always in the same... Never mind.
Take care, since there's not much there. I want to try a bit in my hut.
Well, I thought... Didn't you say I should take care since there's not much there? Now you can sprinkle it on a variety of things and light torches. Use it on your enemies and see what happens. If you run out, go to the forest, pick some mushrooms, and I will make you more. Oops. I wonder if I can sprinkle it on her rat. No. If you don't stop hiccuping, I'm gonna personally come over there and kick your ass. Toad? Toad! You too. Sprinkle it on this guy and you can actually talk to him. you can actually talk to him. Hey, man! Ow, 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 ow. Was that taking damage in the dialogue there? That's rude. You know what's interesting, actually? I'm pretty sure this is one of the only games, aside from, I think Cadence of Hyrule also did this. Hey, it's a pizza power! You got a pizza power! You can feel the energy! Why am I reading that? Oh my god! Are you kidding me with this? Yeah, give me some health. I'm dying. And I don't want to die. This music is so ridiculous. This video is going to be so pathetic. Okay, so now we just gotta go over here. Back to where that Tanuki was, and we can use the powder on his doze. Here you go. How about a little whiff of shame? Good lord. The last thing I can remember was biting into a big juicy toadstool. Then I had the darndest dream. I was a raccoon. Yeah, sounds strange, but it sure was fun. It was fun. Whatever. What do you say now? I'm all tuckered out. I think I better set a spell before I head home. Set a spell? I thought it was sit a spell. Hello? Hey, you got the tail key! Now you can open the tail cave. Not the tail cave, but the tail cave gate. Hoot, take the key and go to the tail cave. Retrieve the instrument that is hidden there. Yeah, I go now. The windfish is waiting. Hoot! Hoot! And over here, we can't do anything here. Jeez, get away from me, asshole. Good lord, these pizza powers are so violent. You can talk to this guy. I think this guy's name is Olryra. It's me, Olryra! That's a crazy name. Reminds me of my character, Ureli.
Ask me anything about the island. If you get lost, give me a call. Bye!
Okay. I think that guy on the other side of the, oh, and this is the swamp. Well, I'm not interested in getting killed by a gator in the swamp today. But, I think that one right there. Ogopongo Swamp. Why does the swamp have a name that the forest doesn't? I think that might be where you go to get pictures taken. I don't know. I don't know. I don't remember.
Da da boom 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 da 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 da
da, 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 da. All right. I guess you should go over to Tail Cave, huh? Where is that? He said it was south of the village. Is there an exit to the south? I didn't think there was. I think you just gotta go... Excuse me. Man, my throat is so full of shit. Tell you what, man. Brings back memories. Feels like home. Like when Tim fell into fourth place in Mario Party 2 and he was just like, feels like home. It's somewhere around here. Man, so many rupees. I don't think anybody's ever dropped fivers in this game, which kind of, here we go, yeah, here it is. Which kind of sucks. Anyway, pop the key in here. This is such a cuck feeling inducing area. I would totally, you know, actually, I shouldn't spoil it, but later in the game, you'll get like a follower, and if you actually bring them here, then when you come outside, they'll be sitting right here, just like looking at the sky. They'll like literally have a different pose, just sitting here looking at the sky, like just like going, "Whoo!" It's like so cute. Anyway, we'll enter the Tail Cave and end this episode here. Oh my god, hope you guys are excited for Link's Awakening, and no comments about the remake, please. Next time on Link's Awakening, we will do the Tail Cave. You know, when just Roy comes in and waxes their tails a bit. Bye!